Okay, what we're gonna do now is build some block leads. We're gonna use 8-inch blocks. We're gonna build a corner lead. We're gonna build a straight, a jam lead out of block. First, we're gonna do a corner lead. Take a framing square. You can see, put it down here. Got our marks to go by. All right? Now we're gonna do a framing. We're done with the framing square, so we're ready to lay some blocks. Now what I'm gonna do is go 5 courses. I'm gonna lay 3 block this way, 2.5 block this way. All right, so you can get the idea of what's going on. All right. Do it just like you were spreading for your brick. Spreading for your brick, go 4 feet. Okay? Now then you want it to be 8 inches wide. 8 inches wide, okay? Alright. Now what you gotta do, gotta be sure you got a jam, a solid end. These are stretchers here. You wanna see a solid jam on the outside. Let's take a lay one. Your line, see? Go by your line. Okay, throw them joints on there. Just break out the 2 hands. Block up the 2 hands. Okay. Okay, now we've got the first course laid. Now what we're gonna do is get our Smith level. We're gonna level. Okay? Level on, we're gonna level always the 3 going this way. In other words, I level this side first. Next time when it's going that way, I'll level that side first. So right now I've got the 3 block here. I put the level going this way. Now look under the level, it's perfect. Alright, now then we go over to here, level it. Okay, we got a little bit right there. A little bit more. There we go. She's perfect. All right. Now then, we've got our lines here. So let's take and plumb it. All right. That's perfect. Now let's come down here. We've got our line down here. Now she's perfect. Okay. Now what we have to do is plumb the bottom and the top of the block, okay? On the first course on, we're doing the bottom. Now we're doing the top, okay? Perfect. All right, now we've leveled it so we know that this is plumb. We don't have to plumb this. Go out here and plumb the tail, okay? There she is, plumb. Okay, now then we straight edge the bottom and we straight edge the top of the first course and the first course only. Okay? Now we need a good place to put our level. Let's just put it right here. That way it's out of everybody's way, and we can go ahead and build this leaf. Alright? Some mud, let's spread the whole course. Now you see all this mud that you got laying on the floor? Go ahead and get it. Don't be so messy. Get the mud. Get it up off the floor. These corner ones, and we lay it on the corner. Okay. Use your eye best you can. Get it real close. Okay. Get them as close as you can. Let's see, I wonder if we can get some more mud. I think we're going to need a little bit of more mud. Here we go. Let's see. We two that way. Now we're going three this way. Changes. And I always like to use two hands when I'm building a corner. Okay? Do whatever it takes. Just lay that little jewel. You can't just throw it down. You gotta baby it a little bit, hold it up a little. Okay? Baby down. Build leads, you want want to try to build one as small as you can. In fact, sometimes if you can park your pickup truck at one end of the building, just tie the line off dead. In other words, don't build big leads, build small leads. That way you'll lay more block or brick at the end of the day and make more money. Show me the money. The key is setting them down as close as you can by using your eye. Right there is a perfect one side of a corner. Come back over here, put it at an angle, and all of these points should be lined up where they should be touching a level. Right. There we are. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to joint this. I'm going to use a sled runner. Sled runners are the best. I'm going to pick up a little mud in case I need it. You hit your bed joints first. Okay. Chip blocks, go ahead and fix them. Now it's time to fix them. Always start from out here going this way. Always start going that way. And we're, don't go through here, you'll pull the mud out. There you go. Yeah. Over on this side. Same thing. Straight lead right into here. Just a straight partition lead, not a corner lead. Okay. Well, here's what we got going now. This is called just a partition lead. In other words, it butts in, it's a wall, it butts into another wall. Now there's several ways to do this. One, you could just drive a 2x4 up, mark it off, you wouldn't even have to build a lead. But I'm going to show you how to build a lead anyway, okay? Now what I did, I got my straight line on the floor, and I took that straight line, I plumbed it up. Now as I build this thing, all I'm going to have to do is level every course and plumb the tail, because this is already plumbed, and there's no need to re-plumb it. Okay, here we go. Be able to see your mark out there. And always make sure if you're laying 8-inch block, spread for 8-inch block, don't spread way over here. Always think what you're spreading for the first course. Okay? See, a lot of people make that mistake. All right, now then, we just take, put a little mud on it, and stick it down there. Right here, get another one. lead. Because we've already got our line here. I just told you, never take the trowel out of your hand, and I did. Sometimes you gotta do whatever it takes. Make it easy. It requires thinking. Gotta think every once in a while. Set that trowel down again. Hemmed up the corner here, so we gotta do it. Set the heavy down. See, I'm still on my mark here. The chip over on this side, I just pointed it up. Perfect. Right there. You got the line there. Don't need to thread it because you're there. Okay. Normally you never level a half. Put it up here, as you can see. Right on. Take the straight edges down, all the way. We've got a perfect lead here. Okay. I'm going to take and joint this thing. This to be flush. Don't joint this. You want it to be flush. Need a little mud? Get it. That mud to be flush. That corner to be flush. joint it again, remember? First time you joint it, get the head joints, then the bed joints. Second time you joint it, get the bed joints and then the head joints. Okay? This concludes the block leads. Now we're going to go build some brick leads. Once again, we took a framing square, we marked it out on the floor. Now we're ready to lay brick, a brick corner. Now, once again, I'm going to stress the importance of don't build great big leads. All right? Build short leads. Less time you spend building leads, more brick, more block you get in the wall. That's the name of the game. Okay? Here we go. Done just rolling that mud. Let's take it furry a little bit. Okay. Here we go. Got some nice, pretty brick. Red brick. Okay. Put one down there. Pretty brick. The rougher they are, the better they look. Okay. I'll go four one way. We'll go three and a half this way. To build, unless you just want to play. Don't need to be planned. Okay, that's level. That's level. Okay. Now then, you can see your line. That's your first course down. Okay. Now then, we can grab you some mud. Okay. Throw that mud. Throw the whole thing. A little bit. You need a little bit of mud someplace. Take and put it where you need it. Pick up the mud anywhere you can. Keep it as neat as you can. Okay. in the corner. Okay, now shredded it. Okay. Come around here now, along the corner, along the tail, and shredded it. Be very careful when you throw it down there so you don't kick everything around. Get your level. Go this way first because your hole breaker going that way. Put it right. Always put the bubble right in the center of your work. Okay. In other words, you wouldn't want to try doing it like that. Put the bubble, what you're going to be looking at, in the center of the course at your level. Same over here. Okay. Along your tail. Perfect. Along your tail. Perfect. Straight. It's good. Along your corner. Along your tail. Okay. Straight. Mud from there, get an upper head joint for here. you level in the center of your work, the two hole brick going that way first, and turn it around. You don't need a straight edge because you can look right here. Alright. My estimation, this is as big a lead as you'll ever need to build. Unless you just want to play. Close the top, right on. Okay. You don't need a straight edge yet because you can see that it's straight. I didn't know it was possible to make such a crooked brick look so good. Okay. There it is. Perfect lead. We got enough for 1, 2, 3, 7 courses. Okay. Now we're going to take the joint. Okay. Once again, I always like to use these sled runners. You always do the first time around, you always joint the head joints first, then the bed joints. Then when you rejoin it, get the bed joints first and the head joints. Okay? And there it is, folks. Cut it up a little bit, clean it up. Brick lead. Okay. What we're going to do here is a partition brick lead buttoned up against a wall. Once again, somebody may take and drive a 2x4 up here and you wouldn't even have to build a lead. However, we're going to put a line here, that way we will not have to plumb it. And I'm gonna come out about 4 brick, just rack it up, and I'll show you how to do it. Okay? Now you can get your mug where you've got a little area to work with. Throw your mud out. Get your mud the same all the way through. It makes it a lot easier. Okay, get your hat. Lay your hat there. Your tail. You don't have to plumb the jam here because you've got your mark. Okay. Keep your level where you can get it when you need it.
pretty rough. But they sure look good. They're up. Okay? You see?
Level.
And you're on over here. Watch. Still have our line over here. Close up to the top, as you can see, perfectly level. And the tail is perfectly formed, and we're still right on our line. Okay. Perfect number of brick here. We got a real good hobby. That's exactly what we need.
Have to stick his half up here and grip the top.
Okay, just for the heck of it, don't normally level a half, but once in a while, just try to check the level, see if it's still right. We see the right on the money again. Alright. Now all we got to do is nice and flush. Join it up. Real nice and curvy. And we just simply join it again. Like I said, I like to use. Always like to use. Holding it upside down because that's the only way you can do it, close to the ground. And you can simply one thing that you're going to have to learn on the job, somebody's going to have to teach you, and that is when to join. Joint depends on the weather. It depends on if everybody works till 4:30. When I was an apprentice, I thought I was really good whenever the foreman got to where he trusted me enough to leave me after 4:30 and send everybody else home, and I'd be there 7 o'clock at night jointing up all the work. So
So everybody that you work for is going to do it differently. So knowing when to sow it is whenever the mud gets thumbprint hard. Thumbprint hard. Sometimes that might be 5 minutes, sometimes it might be 30 minutes, sometimes it might be 4 hours. So everything depends. Okay, this concludes the lead